We are here today with Tayden the Heat Beltran here in Huntington Beach. How's everything going, my man?
Everything's going good. How about yourself?
Pretty good, pretty good. We know that you've been prepping some big-time fighters, some elite fighters for their upcoming events. You were working with Victor Postol for the Jose Ramirez fight. How did those sessions go?
They went really good. Huge gap in experience between myself and him, but it was a great learning experience for me and a great opportunity as well.
You're at 45 amateur fights, right? So for you, you know, with 45 amateur fights, to go ahead and be fighting like the number five guy in the world at his weight, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it was a great experience. It definitely won in the memory bank for sure.
So you were over at the Wild Card Boxing Club. You know, it was probably a different energy being around Freddie Roach and whatnot. How was that experience?
It was fun. Freddie Roach is very, very humble, great guy. Very positive environment in that gym, so it was a lot of fun.
You know, a lot of people had their predictions for who was going to win between Postol versus Ramirez, but it's a lot different when you're an actual fighter and you're actually in the ring with these guys, prepping them for their upcoming events, because you see some subtleties that the fan is not going to see. What was your prediction for how that fight was going to play out if it did happen?
I think Postol would have won. Postol's a really good boxer, great jab, great right hand. I definitely think he would have won. I think he will win in the upcoming fight that they're going to have.
That's very interesting. I know that Postol's an Eastern European fighter. You came up in Southern California fighting a lot of Mexican-American fighters with a quote-unquote Mexican style. What's the difference between fighting an Eastern European and these kids that have that Mexican style?
So when I box someone with the Mexican style, boxing, I'm not sitting in the pocket trading with them, because I myself am a boxer. So sparring Postol is different for me, because I had to put the pressure on him to help him get ready for Jose Ramirez, because that's how Jose Ramirez fights. So it was definitely a different type of style. He's a strict boxer, a lot of jabs, a lot of straight right hands. So it was definitely a different sparring, different way I was going about my sparring. Not just boxing him, putting pressure on him, smart pressure. It was definitely a great experience.
I know that you're working with some other elite pros, prepping them for their upcoming events. You're working with someone that's going to be fighting Jorge Linares and on the Ryan Garcia undercard. Who are you working with?
Carlos Morales. So I'll spar Carlos Morales 9:30 in the morning, and then after that I'll spar Victor Postol. So that's Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays.
Those are pretty heavy days, man. I got to hand it to you.
They are heavy.
Like you were saying, you're 45 amateur fights, and then you're fighting these world-class guys, and not only are you fighting one, but you're fighting two.
Yeah,
that's pretty awesome. I know that you were going to be slated to be on some pretty big shows last year, like the StubHub and whatnot, and I know that you're going to be looking to turn pretty soon. What are your outlooks on that?
So we're going to have an amateur tournament in March 21st to the 28th. Depending how that will go, looking to go pro in April. So that's the main goal right now.
When you came up in Huntington Beach, Huntington Beach is an MMA hotbed. Mm-hmm. It's not really known as a boxing hotbed. How was it getting your name out there, being kind of one of the top prospects in the Huntington Beach area? Did you have any adversity? Was it kind of tough getting sparring? Or?
I'm from Huntington Beach. This is where I box out of, but my gym is in Garden Grove. So there's a few gyms out there in Garden Grove for boxing. But I kind of liked growing up in an MMA environment. There's not a whole lot of boxers here in Huntington Beach, so that kind of made me different, you know. So I kind of like being I'm sure there's some boxers in Huntington Beach, but I like being from Huntington Beach. Being a boxer kind of makes me different from everyone else.
I know, it gives you a little bit of a competitive advantage in a sense.
Definitely.
You were working on, you know, the U.S. Olympics. Mm-hmm. That was one of the things you were working on this last year. And I know you ran into a couple setbacks. How did that play out?
Definitely was bummed about it. Olympics were my dream, but unfortunately that had to come to an end. 2019 was a rough year for me. I separated my shoulder a total of 3 times. 2 weeks out from Olympic qualifiers in Ohio, I separated my shoulder again. So I had to go to Olympic qualifiers just using my left arm. For myself though, I was happy that I did it, showed my heart and my balls for the tournament. Unfortunately, I lost the first day out there, But I have no regrets other than the fact that I could have done a little more recovery on my shoulder. But now I'm healthy, healthier than ever, training hard, and haven't had any problems with it since. So we're good to go for 2020.
Sometimes fighters fight a lot about themselves through injuries and coming back from them and definitely finding out, you know, and also the spectator themselves, the fans find out about, you know, the heart and who those fighters are made of when they mm-hmm. when they continue and they show more perseverance.
Exactly.
So we got an upcoming fight coming up. We got Tyson Fury versus Deontay Wilder. How do you see that playing out?
I think Fury's going to take it. I really do. He's a great boxer. I love Tyson Fury's style and charisma and character. I think he's gonna do good. You just got to be careful because Deontay Wilder, he just needs that one punch. You know, he's a very strong fighter. But I do think Fury's going to take the W on that one.
Cool. Tate in the Heat, Beltran, Huntington Beach's top boxing prospect. Thank you for your time today. Also,